guys, welcome back to my channel. I've been on a minimalism journey for a couple of years and I'm actively trying to live a more sustainable lifestyle for a year now. And both things really have been growing on me and it's a self-enhancing process. So by living more sustainably, I am getting more conscious of all of my actions. So I'm constantly looking for new ways in which I can be more eco-friendly because it makes me feel really good. And I specifically said that I am actively living a more sustainable lifestyle because I've always thought that sustainability is very important, but I never was willing to compromise my own luxuries for the well-being of the planet. And that is what this video is about. In the Western world, many of us are so spoiled with a lot of wealth. Almost everybody drives a car, we have a lot of technology, everything gets instantly delivered to your doorstep, even groceries, and technology is taking over more and more tasks that we used to do by hand, like vacuuming, mopping the floor, mowing the grass, doing the dishes, doing the laundry. We even have self-cleaning toilets. I used to think, why would I be missing out on all of those luxuries if everybody else is enjoying them? But if we all think like that, nothing will ever happen. And I think it would be good for the planet if we would all take a little bit of inconvenience for granted. I think as humans in general, we have two options collectively. We can either choose to keep over-consuming and destroying this planet and we suffer with the consequences of climate change, a heating planet. And I think that's a lot more uncomfortable than choosing an eco-friendly, more sustainable lifestyle collectively in which we can all enjoy a comfortable climate and not die from the heat. So I set myself some goals for ways in which I'm trying to be a less spoiled human being. And the first one is that I'm going to take the bike more often. We already sold our car early spring, but I still have a scooter and I would often grab the scooter even for short distances because it's convenient, it's quick, and I wouldn't get sweaty and tired from it. And a scooter does burn a lot less fuel than a car, but it's still polluting the air. So from now on, for short distances, I'm only taking the bike, and I'm going to bike to work, which isn't what I consider a short distance. I have to bike 17 kilometers to work, and it takes me about an hour, depending on the weather. When it's really stormy or other extreme weather, I am going to take the scooter. But all the other days, I will take the bike. And I actually already started this week, and I really loved going to work by bike. I did get really sweaty and tired though, but it also made me feel very healthy and fit, so I loved it. The second goal I set for myself is to stop buying cheese and butter. I eat a vegetarian diet, but I'm not vegan. I wouldn't say I'm dairy intolerant, but I am quite sensitive to dairy. So I already switched to soy milk quite a while ago, but I was still eating cheese regularly and I would use butter for cooking every now and then. But you actually need quite a lot of milk to make cheese or butter, so that's not great for the environment, nor is it animal friendly, because cows in milk production still need to get a calf every year to keep the milk flow going, and if it's a bull, it will still get slaughtered. So that's just not in line with my values. Before, I didn't want to give up on cheese because I often used it as a meat replacement in meals, and I just really love cheese. But I've come to realize that I can live happily without cheese or butter, because it's not like I will be starving. There are so many people on this planet who do not have enough to eat that I just want to be grateful for the abundance of healthy foods that are available to me, and I shouldn't be complaining because I want cheese. The third one is I'm avoiding supermarkets like a pro. Well, not entirely, but we are trying to eat as much homegrown food as possible. We did grow some veggies for the past couple of years, but this year was the first year that we had a bigger veggie garden. And the veggies are really yummy, completely organic, and almost for free. It made me dream about being self-sufficient. That would be so cool. It's not happening anytime soon, but we are planning on expanding our veggie garden to 3 times the size it was this year. So next year we will have a lot more room to grow veggies. Growing your own food is a lot more work, and after you've been brushing the mud off your carrots for 30 minutes before you can eat them, you really are connected to your food in a different way. Growing your own food is more eco-friendly because you don't use toxins and you don't need transportation of the food, there's no need for refrigerators to keep them fresh, etc. And when we do need to buy food, I try to avoid supermarkets as much as possible because they contribute a lot to the food waste problem and I like to support that as little as possible. So I try to buy as much at farmers markets or locally. And I only go to the supermarket for things like soy milk, beans, olives, spices, things that are just hard to get elsewhere. Since I found out about Too Good To Go, I've only been eating bread that has been saved in a bread box. It's not always my preferred type of bread, but I try to be grateful for all the bread that I can save from the trash. The fourth one is actually not a new goal, but a goal I set for myself in spring, and it is to buy secondhand as much as possible. We already have so much stuff on this planet, we really don't need to produce so much new stuff. If we would stop producing stuff and actually start using what there already is available on this planet, we would probably be good for another 5 to 10 years. So by buying secondhand, I'm trying to lower the demand of new stuff being produced. I never liked thrift shopping for clothing, but now that we have the internet, it is so much easier. I can buy exactly what I want in the right size for way cheaper. I recently replaced a pair of jeans. The fabric got so worn out and thin that it got a hole in it, and I found my favorite jeans secondhand for a fifth of the price. But I also bought a jacket for my dog, I bought a backpack in which I can put my dog so he can travel with me by bike, which is so cute, but also things like a notebook. The variety of things you can buy secondhand is endless. I also try to let my packages be delivered at a post office or at a pickup point, so there is no need for a van driving up to my front door when I order something. Of course, there are a few exceptions like underwear, and when I need to buy underwear, I try to buy from a fair trade sustainable brand. Yes, it is more expensive, but I actually think all clothing should be fair trade, meaning more expensive. It really makes you conscious of what you need and maybe more importantly, what you don't need. Well, we're already at the end of the video. These were 4 ways in which I'm trying to be a slightly less spoiled citizen. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!